Hello, everybody. It is I, Granorite, and here we are back with another episode of Let's Play Pokemon Blue with our Gen 1 type challenge of Fire type. Last episode, we made it down to Fuchsia City, cleared out the routes, 12 through 15? And now we are going to clear out the bike path, and looking level-wise, we'll probably go to Silph after this. We'll see. We'll see how we're feeling. Hope everybody is doing well this morning. Good level up, Moltres. We'll switch up Charizard. Slash the Mankey. Good deal. Keep moving along here. The great big old wheezing. Ouch. Super ouch. Charizard really took that one across the face. All right, we'll get him back up to full. Keep pushing through the trainers on this route. All right. Another cue ball here. This one's got the level like 33 Machop. Oh, I guess. No, you haven't leveled up to 38 yet. What am I thinking? Because I think that's what we're getting everybody to. Or was everybody just 36? Alright, got the rare candy. Stomp the Machop. Stop it! Good paralysis. What is in my throat? I didn't make myself coffee this morning. Well, I know what I'm doing after this episode. Mankey. But two times isn't bad. Good stomp. So remember, Ponyta evolves at level 40. This one barely survived. Oh, and it's self-destructed. That's not good. Ponyta's a little low on health. Hung on. Good deal. Alright, this guy with his Machoke. Didn't get a full paralysis. Thank you. Be a rebel. All right, the choke. All right, here's the coughing. He missed the smog attack, good for us. All right, now we switch. We'll just switch to Charizard. Good hit. We'll just finish this fight out and then go heal so we can clear out the other side of the bike path anyways. Alright, we're doing good taking down these poison types. Good level up already, Charizard. Go back to Celadon so we can go get the other side of the bike path and heal Charizard. Swap up Ninetales. All right, this is the guy with two Weezings. Ooh, just barely hung on. That's annoying. Critical hit, tackle. Alright, good job, Ninetales. Alright, we have Moltres back out front. Well, that's not good. Moltres can't hit anything anyways, and things will start dropping minimizes, we're never gonna hit it. We're just gonna speed this up. There we go. We actually hit the next two after that. Very good. I thought surely with that many minimizes, Moltres just wasn't going to hit it. But we got lucky. Cue ball. Good deal. Good, we got it with a fire spin. Get some damage on it before we hit it with a fly or something. Yes, burn the ooze. All right, that puts everybody at 38. Good thing I got the three bird trainers down here. good. Excellent, Moltres. Take him down. Good job, Moltres. All right, one more trainer here. Good. We got the Dodrio. Oh, and a critical hit, too. I think that means we can knock it out if we hit it two more times. Nice. Alright, let's fly to Saffron. We're still 5 levels down across the board from the next gym leader's Pokemons. This is where we start to lag behind, and it's really just because Moltres and having a team of 4, which is fine. She will get pretty close by the time we get done with Silph Co. All right, so we'll get that car key. Good deal, Moltres. And a level up. Very nice. We'll swap up 9 tails. I got a protein, very nice. Go away, Megaton. good morning, Krishnamon. How are you today? Got coughing? You finally set up your 64 plates of Pokemon Stadium? Nice. Nice. Good for you. Glad you were able to do that. The morning's going good. Had a good morning. Child was in a much better mood today. we cleared out the bike path already, and now we're here starting Silph Co. Getting our team up, ready for the next round of gyms. I will have to do the same thing this morning that I did yesterday. I have a meeting in the middle of the morning, and so I'll have to take a break in between my two episodes I do today to go do my meeting. So, not much I can do about it. That is just the way it is. But we should be looking at getting all the way past Koga and Sabrina today, I would say. We're going to be able to get a good portion of Silph Co. done this morning. Oh yeah, I'll have fun with the meeting. Try. We should be able to get a good portion of Silph Co. done this morning in this first episode, and then we'll definitely get it finished up afterwards, and then we'll take out Koga and Sabrina, which will get us set up to be able to finish the playthrough tomorrow. That is the plan, at least. Sometimes plans don't stick to the plan. But we have half an hour of stream left to do as much damage as we can here in Silph Co. Should give us quite a bit of time. Good slash on that Hypno Charizard. Alright, that's this floor clear. We'll go back down to floor 2. I think we're looking at evolving Ponyta into Rapidash this episode. After we get Charizard up to 39, then we switch Ponyta up front, and we just use Ponyta until it hits level 40 and evolves. We'll see about Mega Punching these smaller bats. Oh, we missed. And we're confused. Oh boy. Come on, Charizard. One turn of confusion we can deal with, even if we hit ourselves. Really just didn't want to use up all my slashes on these. That's a good quick attack, Raticate. Who has the worst stats out of the final forms? Please do share. It is Duck. Wow. Explains why Duck was so bad when we used it. Makes me look forward to using it again when we do normal types. Swap the Ponyta. Oh, Duck just got the short end of the stick of a lot of stuff. Oh, poor Duck. Oh, really? Well, that's probably because its defense is so high. And it's pretty decent in its other stats apart from speed. We'll just stop the Cubone. I didn't do as much as I wanted to the first time, so we'll body slam it to finish it off. Alright, we're working towards our final evolution now, everybody. Oh, that is true. I don't really think about Cloyster and attack. You know, it's just one of those things that's not really what comes to mind whenever I think of Cloyster. I don't think Cloyster and equate it with attack. Ah, Weezing, you're the worst. Well, it's probably why Cloyster runs on a lot of, you know, competitive teams for Gen 1. Go away, Weezing. Alright, well, there's 39 for Ponyta. And learning Fire Spin. Ponyta's not really our fire attacker for this fire team, more just our physical attacker. But Fire Spin is good just to lock somebody down for a little bit. Make me quit messing around. One more level, Ponyta! One more level!
Oh, we can do it!
Oh, when do you stomp? Whoops. We missed the horn drill. Try again. Nope. We are still faster, though, which is what we need to hit. There's all our misses that we weren't getting before. Nope. I was hoping we'd hit on the last one. Wasn't the case. Missed with that whole set of horn drills. Yeah, no luck of the Irish for me on St. Pat's Day. Oh, it's alright, Raticate wasted his first turn. Good paralysis. Wonder if this Weezing will level us up. Sure did. All right. And there's our Rapidash. Let's update over here. The team is now complete. Alright, so as we go up and start clearing out the next floor, let's read Rapidash's biology. So Rapidash is an equine Pokemon with cream-colored fur and a pointed horn on its head. It has small red eyes and triangular ears with reddish interiors. Yellow and reddish-orange flames streak from the back of its head to form a long, flowing mane. A short version of the mane trails down its back to its equally fiery tail. Flames are also present on its fetlocks. It has slender legs, each with a single black hoof. Rapidash is a very agile Pokemon. It runs about 150 miles per hour or 240 kilometers per hour, chasing everything that moves in hopes of racing it. With incredible acceleration, it becomes... with incredible acceleration, it reaches top speed in only 10 steps. At full gallop, its hooves barely touch the ground. The faster Rapidash goes, the longer the swaying flames of its mane will become. At an all-out gallop, the blazing mane sparkles, a feature that is said to enhance the beautiful its beautiful appearance. Rapidash lives in grasslands, but it can be seen on mountains in Pokemon Snap. And the Pokedex for Gen 1 for Rapidash. For Red and Blue, says very competitive. This Pokemon will chase anything that moves fast in hopes of racing it. And Yellow says just loves to run. If it sees something faster than itself, it will give chase at top speed. And that is our biology and information on Rapidash. And self-destruct electrode. Aha! But it missed. Get schooled. Good Mega Punch. Sends out a Drowsy. Right. We already finished the fifth floor, so we'll go up to the sixth. One of the four Rocket Brothers! Oh no! Good level up, Charizard. We'll swap up Ninetales. Drop a flamethrower on that poor confused Machoke. These Zubats don't stand a chance. All right. Thank you. You get him, Ninetales. All right. Good critical. That Magnemite's for sure going down. Get out of here, oh, come on, Moltres! Oh, my goodness. Moltres. Hit it! Gonna give me a brain aneurysm missing all these attacks. All right. Get in here. We want to teach Swords Dance. Charizard is making punch for forever and a day, so it's about time we get rid of it anyways. I should have just pecked it. What am I doing? Oh well. Oh wow. You know, I have to say, I really like the setup that we got going with our tracker up top, where we got the two Pokemon with all the flames on their body on the same row, and it's really appealing to the eye to just have all that fire located. Good. Moldrus deserves to be poisoned. Just gonna swap for a quick sec to take out this Golbat so we can heal the poison off Moldrus. Right. Oh, come on, Moltres. Just hit a fire spin. Mother Trucker. Moltres must have got sand in its eyes from one of these fights and never got it out. Alright, we're on floor 8 now. There's only a few trainers here, if we can take them out really quick. Floor 9 is ideally where I'd like to end. This team cannot not be poisoned. It's just a constant state of being. Oh, yay, Moltres leveled up. Took forever and a day. You get him, Charizard. Alright, well, we made it to floor 9, and so this is where we're going to end our morning episode. I do have a meeting, like I said, at 9 o'clock, which is 40 minutes. I'm not sure how long that meeting will go, so it'll probably be an hour, hour and a half before I'm back with my next episode for the day. Just keep an eye out for a notification that I come live. Also, in between episodes, I am going to go get the TM for Hyper Beam so we can teach it to Charizard. So when we come back, hopefully we'll have that. Hope you all have enjoyed the stream this morning, and we'll see you later today. Take care, everybody.